Welcome into the K0LWC Ham Shack. Today, we're doing a head-to-head comparison testing noise cancellation on some of the most popular DMR radios. Now, on the far left, the brand new cream-of-the-crop Motorola R7 that has two microphones, one of them dedicated for suppressing background noise. Will that one win? Then on the next one, we have the Motorola 7550E that also has noise cancellation technology from Motorola, but it's only using one microphone to do it. Will the R7 beat that? We're about to find out. And then, of course, on the right side, the most beloved DMR analog radios out there for ham radio, the Anytone 878, will also do that one. So what I'm going to do is head outside, start up my gas lawnmower. I'm going to put my head down near the engine, get it as loud as possible, and start using each of these radios. And you'll be able to listen and compare and see how each of them sound. Let's give it a go.
Up next, we have the 7550E from Motorola with the enhanced auto noise suppression turned on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The K0LWC testing noise suppression of the 7550E. And finally, we have the Motorola R7 testing noise suppression next to the gasoline engine while running about 2 feet away. This is K0LWC testing on the gasoline engine noise suppression on the Motorola R7. K0LWC 12345 54321 testing.
All right, that was just crazy. Actually, it went just about like I thought it would. Now, I did take a decibel reading where I was holding the radios, literally like a foot and a half, 2 feet from the running engine. It was 99 decibels. I mean, it was loud. So as I'm down there on the radio with the Anytone 878, you heard it obliterated. You could just get little blips and pieces of it. The radio didn't know what to do. It was intermixing the background with my voice and didn't know what was what, and it was pretty much uncopyable 100%. Now, the 7550E did much better, but the noise was still there in the background, but my voice was able to intermix and be totally audible above that noise. So there was enough separation to be copyable, but you can definitely still hear that noise in the background. Then you go to the Motorola R7. The Motorola R7, I think, is clearly the hands-down winner. There was much more separation, really knocking down that background lawnmower noise to almost nothing. It was a richer sound, a fuller sound, a more intelligible sound. So I think you really see the advantages of having that back microphone on the back of the radio really go to work and give you the best possible audio, even though you're in an incredibly loud environment. So, does this surprise you? Drop me a comment. I'm curious. Or drop me a DM too. You can catch me on Twitter or on Instagram at K0LWC. I gotta say, this is sometimes where when people go out and buy cheap radios and then they get flack from other hams saying, you shouldn't do that. Whether it's doing this, taking a cheap radio into a noisy environment, taking a Baofeng up to the top of a summit next to a radio tower and wondering why the radio can't hear anything because the front end's overloaded. I mean, these are examples of why there are radios out there that can do amazing things and are engineered and are quality compared to a radio that costs less than a pizza these days. So there are differences in these things. So it really depends how you're going to operate and if you're going to be in a challenging environment. You can see how the Motorola shines over this Anytone 878 as much as I love my Anytone, because I really do. It's a fantastic radio, but the clear winner here is the Motorola R7. So again, drop me a comment down below. Thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you again next time.